Well, Tom, congratulations. Can you just describe for us that feeling when you crossed the finish line today?
It's an amazing feeling. I mean, 8-1 down, I thought there was no chance really. We all believed that we could do it, and then the hardest bit was really starting to climb the mountain. Once we started the ball rolling, we won one, we won two, we won three. We felt like we'd started, and we had this huge wave starting to build. And then today, yeah, it just felt like we were never going to lose. We went out there, we were behind, but yeah, we knew that we were going to catch them, and the whole team believed it, and it's an amazing feeling.
Crossing the finish line's one thing, getting that trophy and holding it up in front of thousands of screaming fans, that must have been another.
Oh, for sure, and I mean, the last 12 months for me, or 13 months, has been a whirlwind. My two biggest goals in my career was going to be the gold medal in the Olympics and winning the America's Cup. I've somehow ticked off two in 13 months. I thought it would take ideally 20 years, but I'm very fortunate. I've been part of a great team, and yeah, just so stoked.
I was going to ask you about that, because in that time you've also been named the AIS Sportsman of the Year. You've had an incredible run of late. What do you put that down to?
A bit of luck, I guess. No, everything just falling into place. I mean, a while ago I signed with Oracle, and yeah, I mean, I signed with one of the best teams, a defender of the America's Cup, and even though Team New Zealand have been the benchmark the whole way through, we always believed we'd beat them, and yeah, it's amazing we did. I can't believe the odds against us, but we still stuck it out and won.
Can you compare the feelings at all standing on the podium in London and getting that gold medal around your neck as an individual mostly, but and then obviously holding up the America's Cup?
Pretty different. I mean, one's an individual and I worked hard, and that will be so special for the rest of my life, winning that gold medal. And then winning with a team, a huge team, the race crew's 11, and all the different personalities, all the mixing, and you've got to have the team just right. If one person isn't clicking in the team, you've got to change. You've got to keep rotating the crew until we find that right mix, and we found that right mix, and it was just how much goes into winning a big team event. It's unbelievable.
In London, proudly wearing green and gold, today you've got Team USA branded on your chest. That must be a bit of a confusing, different. How do you feel about it?
For me, look, the America's Cup, it's a professional sport. The Olympics is you represent your country. And the America's Cup, it's a professional game. And Australia doesn't have an America's Cup team, which is pretty unfortunate because we've got so many good sailors.
Would you like to see them return?
Oh, for sure. If Australia get a team going, that'd be the best thing. We've got all these amazing sailors. It's sort of like, I don't know, the Brazilian soccer team, but not having a field to play on or something. You've got all the best people there, and you just unfortunately can't play the game. But I think if we got an Australian team going, it would be awesome. But this is a professional game. Like, you get hired by professional teams, and it's great that sailing is a sport like that, where it's grown so much that you can be hired by some of the best teams around the world.
Tom, congratulations. I really appreciate your time. Well done today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.